And me and the pool in a shankle road, left the man called William Blount. Now here the wife, the curse of his life, who continually got his goat, till one day at dawn, with her nightdress on, he cut her bloody throat. Where is her gash? She settled her house, she never was crammed so quick. But the steady drip on the pillow slip of his lifeblood made him sick. And the pool of gore on the bedroom floor grew clotted cold and thick. And yet he was glad he had done what he had as she lay there stiff and still. But the sudden awe of the angry law struck his soul with an icy chill. So to finish the fun so well begun, he decided himself to kill. Then he took a sheet off his wife's cold feet and he twisted a gentle rope and he hanged himself from the pottery shelf. It was an easy end, let's hope. With his latest breath and the throes of death, he solemnly cursed the Pope. But the strangest turn to the whole concern is only just beginning. For he went to hell, but his wife got well and is still alive and sinning. For the razor blade was Hong Kong made, but the sheet was Belfast linen.
All right, hold on. I will bring a bit of culture to the proceedings. Bit of culture, agriculture. Bit of culture. William.
Sorry.
William wheeled his horse. The hot boys played. Drums we did beat and rattle.
Yes.
And Lily Bolero we did sing, a going into battle. Both horse and foot, they came o'er intending us to batter. But the brave Jude Schomberg, he was shot as he crossed o'er the water. When King William he perceived the brave Duke Schomberg falling, he reined his horse with heavy heart at his innocent skillener's calling.
Right.
What will you do for me, brave lads, yonder our men retreating? Our enemies encouraged are, our English drums are beating. Follow me and I will lead you on. Boys, use your hands full nimble, and with the help of God we'll beat them all and cause their hearts to tremble.
Yeah.
We formed our bodies at the ford, and across the stream did swatter. Each man held his fellow fast,
yes,
as we did cross the water.
Yeah.
But oh my stars, had you been there, as we their trench came under, sulfur and smoke did fill the air, and the elements did thunder.
Where the eyes that look so mild are roo, where the eyes that look so mild are roo, where the eyes that look so mild in my poor heart you first beguiled, why did you scuttle from me and the child? Johnny, I hardly knew ya. With your gums and drums and drums and gums, a-roo, a-roo,
a-roo.
Your gums and drums and drums and gums, a-roo, a-roo, a-roo. With your gums and drums and drums and gums, the enemy nearly slew ya. Darling dear, you look so queer, Johnny, I hardly knew ya. Where the legs with which you run, haroo, haroo. Where the legs with which you run, haroo, haroo. Where the legs with which you run, the day you went to carry a gun. Indeed, your dancing days are done, Johnny, I hardly knew ya. Your gums and drums and drums and drums, a-roo, 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 a-roo. Your gums and drums and drums and drums, a-roo, 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 a-roo. Your gums and drums and drums and drums, the enemy nearly slew ya. Darling dear, you look so queer, Johnny, I hardly knew ya. You haven't an eye, you haven't a leg, a-roo, a-roo. You haven't an eye, you haven't a leg, a-roo, a-roo. You haven't an eye, you haven't a leg. You're an armless, noseless, chickenless egg. You'll have to be put with a bowl to beg. Johnny, I hardly knew ya. with your drums. Here comes the drums, and comes the roo, a roo, a roo. Here comes the drums, and drums, and comes the roo, a roo. Here comes the drums, and drums, and comes the enemy near the studio. Darling, there you look so queer. Jamia, and sad it is to see you so, haru, haru. And sad it is to see you so, haru, haru. And sad it is to see you so. I think of you now as an object of woe. Your Peggy will still keep you on as her bow. Darling, there you look so queer. Yummy, hallelujah.
Lovely, man.
Wait. It was the morning of the Battle of the Boyne, and we scraggy came before your day. Goes up to King Billy and he says, "Your Majesty, I'd like to go into battle by your side." And King Billy looked down at wee Kiwi and he says, "Son, you don't look very healthy to me." But he says, I tell you what, he says, "If you go see the doctor," he says, "and the doctor passes you, I'll let you lead my horse." So wee Kiwi goes up to the medical tent, strips off, the doctor examines him. Wee Kiwi looks up and he says, "Well, doctor, what about man?
What about man?
What about him?
Was it the big doctor?"
It was a witch doctor. So the doctor looks down at wee Kiwi and he says, "Son, the medical makeup of man is that he smells with his nose and he runs with his feet." Yeah. But he says, "Huey, you have defied medical science because your nose runs and your feet smell."
What is that, the basic advice? Hey, wait a minute. I have a special request. Never mind, I have a special request.
Right, Joe's a special request.
Right.
Go ahead, Joe.
"A loyal bond of orange men, yes, from Worcester's lovely lawn. They could not march upon the 12th. Processions were all banned. So off they went to the Middle East, this dreadful law to dodge. And they found it in Jerusalem, a narrow Bourne's lodge."
Brilliant.
"Big Ollie Begg, who charmed the sneaks, he was the first recruit. John James McKeag from Port Glenoon taught him to play the flute. And as the Earl paid paper was once swallowed by the rat, there followed Ollie in the lodge 10 sneaks and bowler huts." Here, wait a minute. "They made a martial picture as they marched along the shore. It stirred the blood when Ollie played the phase my father wore."
Just like that.
"And Yusuf Ben Muhammad at the long bag, such a bush. It stirred the 11 daylights from a camel in a sash." "Now the movement spread both far and wide. There was lodges by the score. The Jerusalem Purple Heroes was the first of many more. The Loyal Sons of Jeddah and the Mecca Purple Star and the Raising Sons of Jericho who came by motor car. The Apprentice Boys of Ammon marched beneath the blazing sun. The Royal Black Preceptory were Negroes, every one. And lodges came from Egypt, from the Abu Simbel Falls, and they shouted, 'No surrender! And we'll guard our Cairo's
Sam Cookie couldn't do it.
Wait a minute.
"Sorry, but you're finished. Carry on."
"Now the bonners too were wonderful, and some would make you smile. King Billy on his camel as he splashed across the Nile. But the tyrant Sidon Temperance had the best one of them all, for they had a lovely picture of Damascus Orange Hall. But when the ban was lifted and the lodges marched at last, the Arabs all decided for to march right through Belfast. And the coast a lot of trouble before they got afloat. For they couldn't get the camels and the bloody hessian boat. Now camels blocked up Liverpool, and camels choked Stranraer, and the Sheikh of Kuwait came along and this great big motor car. But the eastern magic gale away, and they worked the crafty move. They got on their magic carpet and flew into Aldergrove. Now, when they got to Castle Junction, where once stood the wee kiosk, they dug up Royal Avenue to build the Flaming Moss.
Must do, it must do.
And Devlin says to Jerry Fitt, I think we'd better go. There's 500,000 camels coming down from Sandy Romania's up there. When they got to the field that day, the speeches were really new. Some were made in Arabic and some were in Hebrew. And just as Colonel Nasser got up to toast the Queen, I woke up in my bed and I found it was a dream.
Hello, hello, hello.